Good day, my dear ones. Always a pleasure. Always a pleasure. Boy, are we getting a lot of rain. Holy moly. Boy, I think we've been getting 2.5-3 inches every day. So we're up there. A lot of rain. But boy, my plants are loving it. They're just going, yeah, baby. Good. Well, I hope you're all doing well. You know, there's always controversies, it seems, out there. So on the Facebook sites and all this, let's just run them from the heart. And you know, the whole issue is helping people through their healing crisis and helping people to win their remedy. And you want to always keep things simple and to the point. You start getting too far out and adding things and stuff, you get out of balance, you know. And then sometimes when you add too much in your healing modality, you lose. Sometimes more isn't better. And, you know, some people, you read about supplements and everything sounds so good. And, oh, I got to have this one. And we see this all the time here when people bring in bags. I remember one lady brought in, I mean, she had bags all over my desk, all over the floor of supplements, thousands and thousands of dollars, and she wasn't doing too well. And it just, you know, it's just not focused thinking. It's just the capitalism that we have out there, that we have product and we want to make money on it, that's wrapped up in treatment-based thinking, and it's just, oh, a mess sometimes. Anyway, I wanted to get some Q&As done today. This is Monday morning. How was your weekend? Good. I got a lot of work done, I think, through the weekend. Call a few of you guys up. I know a lot of you are hurting. I get letters from you, and I appreciate the pain and suffering you're in. And don't worry, we're going to do everything we can to help each and every one of you guys. One way or another, we're building a powerful team of all of you guys and all of us to meet this demand. Because once people wake up and they start seeing you're getting well, they want to know how too. Because this has been lost. For some reason on this planet, getting well has been lost. And it's like, what? It's always been one's lifestyle. It's always been what you eat, drink, breathe, and what you put on your skin. It's always been that. To think that what you eat, what you drink, what you breathe, and what you put on your skin chemically has no effect or has no relationship to your suffering, I think is pretty far out there, and any health modality that would call them a health modality should lose that title, because there's no such, to not know that would be not to know chemistry, and then if your modality is steeped in chemistry. Anyway, I wanted to show you some things here. I hope you all had a chance to review the movie by the 17-year-old, or it's not a movie, it's an interview with the 17-year-old in Connecticut that they tied her down and they drugged her, and then they really drugged her with chemo. I hope that state gets a real good look at what they just did. And I hope the child services and the medical doctors get a real good look, because when you're that lost in ignorance and unawareness, you don't even know what you're doing wrong. You have no idea because you're unconscious. And that's, you have to understand, in creation, the problem. This is unconsciousness. And you'll kill people, you'll do anything under unconsciousness, thinking that you're doing, that you're conscious, that you know what's right and wrong and all this other stuff. And you're just living by opinions. You're living from that conditioned mental state. That's why I tell you guys, get out of your minds, because your mind is totally a conditioned instrument. And they've been a lot of years learning how to condition your instrument. And this is true at every level you can imagine. So to get away from conditioned thinking, so you live by purity and love and beauty and honesty and integrity, you've got to get out of your minds. They've been so conditioned at this level, most people don't even know what to believe. And a lot of people believe in things that are not even true. And religion's done a job on people too. Well, we have religious wars all over the place. You think God intended to have religious wars over itself all over the place? Doubt it. Anyway, I wanted to show you some pictures of some vaccines, horrors. This is going out there, of course, and let me tell you, I've had a lot of years. And I remember when, I guess it was a class action lawsuit against pharmaceutical companies. I can't remember what state. It seemed like Texas, but I can't remember what state it was in. And the pharmaceutical companies actually won this. Being in front of federal judges as much as I have, I wouldn't trust one of them. A federal judge would have to prove to me that they have honesty and integrity, because a whole bunch of them are crooks. I mean, when it comes down to it, we live right now and money buys everything, including the Supreme Court. You know the Supreme Court's fixed. Look at Roberts. Bad stuff. It's just people wanting to tell other people how to live instead of enjoying the beauty of the Constitution in this country, which grants freedom to everyone, except not to hurt anyone. You should have a right to do anything you want as long as you don't hurt anyone. Anyway, I remember on Fox News, this young woman has a health program on there. I can't remember. Seems like it's around the 4 o'clock hour or so. And she had a medical doctor. It's one of the Fox News analysts. And then she brought a naturopath on. And the discussion was about vaccines. And that medical doctor chewed that poor naturopath up. That naturopath, no offense, but she wasn't very bright. You don't go in to a medical doctor and converse on vaccines unless you have all your facts in line, because they've been so brainwashed. They'll fight on what they think is an improvement of the condition of man because of vaccines. What they don't realize, a lot of medical doctors, is that they were lied to. And Dr. Tenpenny, I've talked about her before, came out with a cassette. I don't know if it's a DVD. I've been trying to get her DVD, if she even has it. She actually went into CDC centers, visited them, and looked up their stats and stuff, and found that the CDC centers themselves had lied to medical doctors, had hidden facts. And I think it was Wallach or one of them with the emerging virus. The Emerging Virus is a good book. I think it's just another good book to show you the horrors of what man's doing. We live in such a horror place medically. When you stop and back up and take a look at what man has done to promote medical thinking and to promote some idiocy of that man's fighting some phantom diseases, we need to slaughter and maim and harm millions of animals to try to find some cure for something that doesn't even exist. We have gotten so bad that everywhere I go out of body, oh, you're there. Humans. This consciousness has got to be shooken and balanced out, because it's so erratic. The Homo sapien consciousness is way, I've never visited any place where they had different species that I ever saw anything like the Homo sapien species. It literally is destroying itself. And so we got to try to infuse it a little bit, try to turn that around a little bit. But it's amazing. This mind is so conditioned at this level here. And it's just full of falsehoods and idiocies and things like this. It's amazing. I have worked on thousands of young children that had ADD or ADHD or seizures from vaccines. And I mean right after the vaccines, they go into these. And I've told you about this one sweet, sweet girl. She's 27 probably now. It had, 50 seizures a week or a month, grandma included. It makes you sick, because the ignorance is so high and the arrogance is so high. You never put live pathogens, and I'm going to use the word pathogens, but I disagree with that terminology, of microbes, virals included, in vaccines. Because the problem always, mumps, measles, chicken, I don't care what it is, has always been the culturing medium. These conditions are all lymphatic conditions. that are just natural processes. And a person does not die from any of these things. They develop a natural immunity toward these type of virals, these type of proteins. At the same time, it's in our face to clean our sewer systems, our immune systems up. It's in our face. It's not about building your immune cells. Most people have adequate immune cells. It's cleaning the highway. It's cleaning the system that's involved in cleaning the human body for you. That's what's trashed up. And it's trashed up from all the foods. Most of the foods man eats on this planet is lymphatically trashing people. It's just the body doesn't want it. So it's creating a lot of mucus buildup in people. A lot of inflammation in people because most foods people eat are acid forming. So it's created a whole hell. All over nothing. This is just simple. You just eat your fruits, live your lives, and enjoy it. That's how all the other animals do. Primates have fun. They make love all the time. They play. They have fun. They eat what they're in, and that's life. We're fighting, putting people in jail over health, and those are the people that are killing everybody, coming after the innocent people. It is so bad on this planet. It's been war between the natural health people and the medical community for years. Now they're moving in our field so heavily, I don't know where the war is anymore. If we're all wrong, then medical doctors don't come into our field if we're all wrong. But you guys are coming into our field faster than we can even think. These are some graphic images. So if you don't want to watch these, turn away. And I've got a bunch. You guys can see some of our tumors and stuff. But this is all from immunization. This is all from vaccines. Of course, this isn't the standard. But your child could end up as one of these. And I have plenty. I have a picture from the Tampa Tribune of a mother looking down at her little baby in a little stroller. And she has this painful look on her face, the mother. And it says, baby contracts polio from the vaccine. Right in the front page of the Tampa Tribune. What they don't understand is when, and I think it's the doctor that wrote Emerging Virus. I don't think it was Wallach. Anyway, had found that polio actually went up 685 or something like that percent when they stopped inoculating for polio. Well, of course, why would you think, this is a homeopathic thinking, there's a little allopathic thinking, or homeopathic thinking in naturopathic thinking. I was just getting ready to show the pics. You know it?
Bring my chair.
Bring your chair. Just getting ready to show the pics.
Hello, everyone.
You remember Marcy, right?
No.
Did we ever find out about that woman? She said we could. Anyway, we don't have to mention any names, but another good win. Yep, there's another lady there running around without leukemia. Of course, her medical doctors can't figure out why she doesn't have leukemia anymore. Oh, wow, and I think, didn't your woman tell her that I know how? Yeah. You know, a lot of people have never told their medical doctors how they got rid of their problems. They were afraid to tell them they used herbs and diet. It's like, why be afraid? Tell them the truth.
Well, there's been a number of doctors that have said, I don't know what you're doing, and I don't want to know what you're doing, but keep doing it.
Keep doing it. Oh, I've heard that all the time, you know. And it's like, why wouldn't you want to know?
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're truly a doctor of any level, for the humanitarian side of that, the capitalist side of this, then you would really want to know, because it's like the medical doctor in Canada that came down, he gave me a great big hug and he said, you know, I just cured a lymphedema case. We don't cure lymphedema. And the reason he cured the lymphedema case as a medical doctor, because he now understood the lymph system.
Mm-hmm.
And he understood the kidneys, and then he cured his patient right up. That's what I'm talking about medically. But there's so many narcissistic medical doctors that think they're all in the right and all the money they spent for their education and all this stuff that we possibly couldn't be right having similar education. Naturopathic education is real similar to allopathic education, except we don't have the amount of time studying diseases because
mm-hmm.
we don't treat diseases.
So I had a doctor that found out I was going to be a ND soon, and I was teasing him about don't kick me out of your yard, and he's like, I don't care, you can play wherever you want to play, just don't get in my way, is basically what he was saying.
Yeah, interesting.
So I thought to myself, what have you claimed as your territory?
Yeah, exactly.
Where have you usurped, where have you taken authority over areas that are not yours?
Exactly. So. You know, the whole thing is just narcissism and stuff, you know. This planet is, none of this, we're just here visiting. We're just here playing. All of us. I mean, nobody owns nothing.
There's a doctor that said, and I just come across this the other day, he said, if it wasn't here 100 years ago, you don't need it. If it wasn't on this earth or created 100 years ago, you don't need it.
Well,
meaning that we need to take things from the earth and nature and utilize those.
No, I'm thinking that means most pharmaceuticals need to go. That's pretty good, Doc, right there. These are horror pictures we want to show you. And when it comes to vaccines and for a state like California, California's slipping into the negative side over and over. They make us label this, put on our labels that this, that our herbs contain lead or something in there toxic, and they got toxic for them and stuff. California is way out of balance. No offense to you Californians, but you, they're definitely a state of out of balance. So now they pass a law to stop any, you know, you, it's mandatory to get your children vaccinated. Well, it's the same, it's a takeoff on strapping a 17-year-old down, bruising her bad, injecting her with a morphine or some type of knockout stuff, and then administering chemo in her. That is as barbaric as you can get. I mean, the next thing is put her on a rack and stretch her out. I mean, it's just that sort of thing. And when you force men, and I was talking to her attorney.
Plus threatening her to do it over and over and over again until she capitulated.
Exactly. And this, if you haven't seen it, you've got to see this. We'll have it up on our site as soon as we can get it up there, but you just got to see this interview to really appreciate that sort of thing.
Well, that's where a fellow student that I go to school with shared this. And when I come across this, and especially the pictures are bad enough, but the video, when you listen to the video at the bottom of this, I literally watched this at 1:30 in the morning and couldn't sleep the rest of the night.
I believe
that's
that.
Why I wanted you to see it.
I believe that. It's vomitous. And what they don't see is the amount of clients we have from vaccinations.
Yes.
And I was telling about the 26-year-old that she's had seizures since she was 4 months old. Imagine being the mother and the father of your baby that has seizures all the time, and you have to live with that day in and day out for 26 years, not knowing whether it'll kill her one time or not, or whether you wake up with lost functions all over the place, all for a vaccine. And yet the people that administer it, they're living their lives not even thinking a thing. And this all has to change. Has to change. Can't do that. So let's just take a look at a few of these pictures.
These are graphic, so
hang on to you.
Yeah.
These are graphic, and I've got other ones in our little portfolio over here. That's probably the least graphic. I've got another baby like this, but she's about 12 years old.
Oh.
Swollen, burnt bad by radiation and chemo with leukemia, and of course she's dead. This one's real bad. Makes you sick to your friggin' stomach.
The worst part is how they are trying to cover this up.
Exactly.
So that you don't know about it.
And yet, they want you to march your babies and get them full of goop up chemistry, and maybe you're lucky, yours won't turn out like this. Maybe you'll be the lucky one.
In the United States, by the time a child is 5 years old, they have received between 40 and 46 vaccinations.
Yeah, they want to load. I was reading this. They want to give a baby right at birth a loaded vac with so much in it. I find these people have gone over to the dark side and are totally unaware of it. And they proudly walk around the halls. And that's nurses who are mothers themselves who have bought into this, who believe this. I've seen RNs just argue and fight over things. These are two-year nurses. There's another one. This is what she looked like before the vaccine. And that's what she is now. Neural and excitotoxicity. And it's just, it's nasty. And for the sake of what? There's no for the sake of nothing. Mm. When you're talking about catching anything, I want you all to think about you're creating the terrain for that. So we're about cleaning the terrain up, because where are you going to live in a bubble? Mm-hmm. There's virals everywhere, and man, in his need to kill each other, I'm sure we're still steeped in heavy chemical warfare. And as you've learned, Ebola and the HIV viruses are germ warfare virals initially. And of course, we have a paper trail of when the HIV was used, what vaccinations, what cities, what years. I mean, that's pretty bad when you realize that all your friends that died of HIV, all of these people, this was government created. And it was planned. It was planned in what cities that they were going to use the HIV virus in. The Hep B was the medium. And look at this. Just look at what our friendly governments and the people we put in power who have no awareness. Look at what they're doing. So you have to elect people with spiritual awareness, because the spiritual people would never hurt each other like this and never do anything like this.
You've got a government that is pretending to be your friends, but they have no longer have our best interest at heart. They no longer have our health. I mean, if you just want to talk one area, if you don't even want to get into politics and talk about this, that, or the other thing, let's just look at health. They no longer have your best interest at heart. Mm-hmm. They no longer have mine at heart.
Mm-hmm. Sad stuff. And you've got to protect your babies and things like this, because what they don't get, and it's in our face, so I don't understand why they don't get. But again, when you get too educated, your mind's so conditioned, you're not free to understand things. Your mind has been set up with millions of little rooms that you can't get out of anymore, because you're chasing your thoughts, you're lost in your mind, so you can't see what we pull back and see the whole of life, and then use the mind to what we need. We don't live in the mind only, because then you're real restricted to what you see and know, and that restriction comes to what you've been educated.
You know, I'm sorry, I'm just a little upset about this, but these pictures, what drug tested would someone be okay with even a couple of these occurrences happening? And yet, this is only reported, these types of instances are only reported 6% of the time.
Wow.
6%. What about all the hundreds and thousands of cases that aren't even reported? What we are doing to our babies and our children?
Yeah, it makes you sick to your stomach. It makes you super sick. And it's for what reason? Because everything is curable when you understand what causes everything. And we control what we've created all this.
Mm-hmm.
You created all the problems in your life. Unconsciously, there's no question. We're all unconscious at any given moment. So we create these things, but it comes from a conditioned mind. Our mind was conditioned to think, oh, Mama cooks good old grits and meatloaf. That sort of conditioning. Mm-hmm. Then your emotions are wrapped into that, and then you'll fight over, you got to have meat. You know, all this stuff is stuff that are conditioned thinking that doesn't have any facts based upon it. And so we have allowed this conditioned mind, we live on that, and so we're ruining ourselves. Mm-hmm. We just don't realize. We don't have this spirituality, which is awareness. The mind has got us trapped into conditioned thoughts. We don't have the awareness to pull back and go, oh, vaccines must be toxic. Look at all the people. No, we don't have that. Oh, it's needed. You know, so it's just the lies and how they capture your attention and your emotional components. They know how to use your emotions.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we know how to use the emotions too. Take a look at the reality of it. Take a look at the truth of vaccinations. And it's sad. These people buy into this sort of thing, into a state to pass mandatory vaccines, when this is, I don't know what percentage that kids are getting out of there, but it's got to be pretty high. Because we just hear this all the time in this clinic of ADD, ADHD, seizures. I can't even tell you.
I wasn't even aware of the damage that vaccines could do. And I wasn't even fully brought into natural and health and healing and all of this. And yet, as a mother, I instinctively pulled back from the vaccines. And probably by the time my kids were 3 and 4, I stopped. I just stopped.
Smart,
and I'm very, very thankful.
Oh my
kids, I'll tell you what, healthy kids. They're strong. The one test that they did, the outbreak of measles, I think there was like 70-some outbreak. The percentage, it was very high, 80s, 90s, of those who got those measles were all vaccinated for them in the first place. So how is this helping? How is it stopping and preventing?
See, and these facts need to be shoved down the throat of medical doctors, or medical doctors need to wake up, quit the pompous, arrogant bullshit, and start realizing we're all human together, and we quit hurting people with toxic chemicals. Go to your herbs, understand detoxification, understand the lymph system, understand acidosis, really simple stuff, easy to prove, and get off your high horses and start realizing you're part of the problem, not part of the, and become part of the solution.
Mm-hmm.
We have to all become part of this solution. Because it's pretty bad. These children are being literally destroyed, and it's like, oh my God, for no reason. And then to have a state make it mandatory,
yeah.
California.
If you don't go out and change it and how you vote in who you're going to vote in, California is only the beginning.
It is.
And it's not just the beginning of the vaccine. It is the beginning of even more and more things being shoved on you and forced upon you.
Oh, yeah. Imagine changing the maturity date to 21. So you take a 20-year-old, strap her down or him down, and give him a knockout drug, and then put a port in, and then go ahead and juice him up. That's real cool.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just, you know, all these futuristic movies you saw years ago, and you're looking at them cringing that we could even come up. We are turning into that.
I don't think we're turning into it, Robert. I think we're already there.
It's probably true.
Yeah.
There's just, I know this got to you. And I just, it gets to me too. I didn't realize it was this bad either. Because I don't deal with babies that are getting so bad from them. We get, the seizures was probably the most difficult. I had one, this was a 18-month-old baby at 4 months, again, about the same as this other girl. At 4 months, this little baby went into a hep B, a loaded back. She went into liver failure. Her left eye wiggled and took a turn east. She went into seizures and convulsions. And I forget, there's a host of things this little girl went into. It took me a month to get her out of seizing. And I got her at 18 months. So she'd been having seizures and all this stuff since 4 months. I had her at 18. We got her cleaned up. But I'm telling you, I remember that. That was a lot of years ago, and I was just sick about that case. And that was too bad. I think it was in Texas or something. But mother finally pulled her out of it. But it was like, holy shit. If the mother had not done our way, that little baby, her eyes would have been turned and all kinds of, because they're neurotoxicity.
That's right.
Horrible. Yeah. You got time? You want to read a couple?
Sure.
All right. Let's go over a couple of these. There's another one. Cleanse neurotoxins from the brain lymph. A study showing that when you sleep, this amyloid plaque is removed by the lymphatic system and the spinal fluid. This is all cool stuff. We're going to have our, we just had a little meeting on our web, and we're going to work with Ning. I don't know what that is. We're going to set up a whole bunch of things on there, and even a site where, kind of like a Facebook site, because we appreciate Brian and all the people working on these sites and everything, but we want everybody to be civil about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's just so much of this going after Marco or going after Brian or going after this. It's like, you know what, guys, just start going working from the heart. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Drop everything and let's just go on. And because what really matters is these poor souls that are hurt and all the people getting on Facebook that need positive, honest, straightforward information. No egos involved, because, listen, everybody's hurting. When you understand this, you're now a good healer, and you start working with that. Try to keep that basic, simplistic understanding, or you'll lose being a good healer. I've trained a lot of people to be good healers, and they start going this way. Oh, if I add colostrum, and then I can add B12, and then I can add this, and I can add that. And pretty soon, they've got them adding all this other crap, and now they're not getting well.
Mm-hmm.
They took them off point. because everything sounds so good. Yeah. You have to understand, I've had a lot of years in using stuff like this, in playing that game. And let me tell you, if I can save you years of going backwards, let me do that.
Well, remember, behind every lemon car that was sold is a good salesman. You can make anything sound good, and you can sell people on stuff.
Exactly. But we're about truth and honesty and integrity.
Know your base.
Keep that. Exactly. Keep that honesty and integrity and love. Because get yours, and then put your hand out to others.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no ego intended. God said, you got yours, now we'll give others theirs.
There is a there's a phrase, speak the truth in love. And this is the thing. When you start backbiting amongst yourself, you've just taken the focus off of health. You've just lost your focus.
Yeah.
And now people are watching the fight that's going on rather than what's the purpose behind it, which is healing and health.
Because we love you all.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
We love you all. And we want everyone, we want to protect this level. And I did a part one on how many years I've worked hard to maintain the integrity of natural healing. I've kept myself shaved. I kept myself wearing nice clothes. I've kept myself going to the...
I think you'd look good with one of those scruffy long beards.
Yeah, you do? I love them, though. Well, I do have my hairline, but you know what I'm saying? I've done everything to try and solidify this level of thinking, because this is where you get your remedy. Mm-hmm. This is the best thing since apple pie. Or chocolate cake, or what?
Raw apple.
Raw. Carob. But this is just putting it all together for you guys. It's all been done for you. It's easy. You don't have to spend years like I have of waiting for customers to come in to work on, to help them, to go out and educate. Mm-hmm. Some of you might, to build your businesses, you know, because it's not always easy to get your clients. But I've given you all the tools. I can even give you the verbiage to where, you just keeping it simple, you're going out and giving a nice little talk, you get your first client, you work your client, you get them well, you put them on the diet, you give them a few herbs, you start cleaning them up. And I'm telling you, you've got a focus you can grab a hold of. A lot of you created new jobs on this already.
Mm-hmm.
So we're opening some doors, but we have to protect the integrity of this level. Natural healing has a bad rap because there's layers a mile long. This layer drinks urine. This one over here does MSM and all kinds of crap. This one over here believes you should have 50% protein. This one over here believes, believes, believes.
Well, there's backbiting within the natural realm,
mm-hmm.
and we need to create unity.
We do.
It's about getting healthy naturally. And the thing is, you have to have a base. I don't care if it's drinking urine. Well, I do. I really do care if it's drinking urine.
But
if it's acupuncture, if it's reflexology, if it's this, those are all tools to put in the basket or on the tool belt.
Mm-hmm.
But the tool belt itself,
mm-hmm.
your base has to be nutrition.
And detoxification.
And understanding the body.
Exactly. That's the core. If you get that, then everything else you can use as therapy. I've said, most of these are therapeutic modalities.
Mm-hmm.
Chiropractic is not a healing modality. It's a therapeutic modality. No offense to chiropractors, but it's therapeutic. Now, they're taking on our field and giving them diets and giving them supplements now. But chiropractor is a therapeutic modality, massage therapeutic, acupuncture therapeutic, biofeedback. All of these are therapeutic. But they sit, like you said, the core is our field, detoxification. We're the core health field. All these therapeutic modalities is what we recommend to help you achieve the core vitality and wellness.
Mm-hmm.
And that has to happen through detoxification, because you know why we got the way we are.
Mm-hmm.
And you just have to play. But you got to realize, again, this is nature's rules. We're just telling you nature's rules. Nature detoxifies.
Yeah.
That's just showing you what the rest of the world does. The problem is you have opinions. Opinions, opinions. The difference is I've had 40-some years of living beings scattered all over this world that got their remedies from some of the deepest, darkest problems you've ever seen. So we have a long, and now she's stacking up the wins. Cancer here, 23-centimeter tumor out of a liver, leukemia.
13.
Okay, gone. Still 13 centimeters, pretty big. Gone. still pretty good. I mean, so, and you guys, I know Shane there's knocking them out like crazy, mm-hmm. just got rid of a lung cancer. I mean, so you guys, you it is, people are suffering and crying for help, and we must come with integrity, godliness, love, because we represent the God force. Mm-hmm. Remember who you represent, the God force, and you want to put your hand out like a God woman or a God man. Because then you get yours. God will give it right to you. You do those sort of things and you'll feel the power coming into your body. Because it's saying, thank you. Thank you for letting me, you know, being a channel so I can use you. So it's a beautiful thing when you do all of that. So just like we say, try to keep it, always keep it simple. That thing, keep it simple, sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thing. Because that'll test the mind. The mind can't stand simplicity because thought is what is the order of the day, right? But thought is all conditioning.
Yeah.
Throw yourself back sometimes and see what else is there.
Don't ascend mentally. Ascend spiritually.
Exactly. 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 All right, so here's, let me see, Dr.
Katya?
Katya?
Yeah.
Dr. Morse, you are. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. In a recent video, you said a guy on your program got skinny because of the malabsorption first. I have been cleansing with herbs and eating only fruit. How long does it usually take to heal malabsorption, and what is the best way to go about it? Also, I have a lot of radi isolarises going up all over my head area. Please recommend the fastest way to cleanse it. I've been taking back walnut, wormwood, and clove buds, but not sure how much I should take. Well, I mean, that's just deworming you and stuff like that. That's all that's doing. So you don't want to go much over a month on a program like that, to tell you the truth, if you're hitting it hard with wormwood and all that. Wormwood's a strong herb. You know, black walnut hulls, no light one either. So, you know, a month worth, if you did see worms, do it for a month, take a break, and then come back about a month and do it again for a month. Because you want to get the eggs and any rehatching and stuff like that. Let's go back to the first question. What is malabsorption in the first place? You can't understand. If you don't understand malabsorption, then you can't understand how you fix it. That's the same thing with everything we have here. And the best way to show you malabsorption, as a matter of fact, we have shown you malabsorption. Go back to the videos we did on the iris pictures. Yeah. And we showed you that thick wall around the gut tissue, that thick lymphatic wall around the GI tract. This comes back every time. Thank God we have iridology, but this comes back to the lymphatic system all the time. So when you see your kidneys not filtering, and we say this is a systemic problem, it is a systemic problem, meaning that this system, because you're not filtering it, is backing up head to toe. Mm-hmm. That's all it is. Remember, your skin is your third kidney. That's simply, you have three eliminative organs that are designed to remove cellular waste. When you look at the size of those compared to the GI tract, you can see the difference. So your skin is a major kidney, and your kidneys eliminate cellular waste. And if you don't eliminate these wastes, they back up. They back up subcutaneously under the skin. So anything you see on your skin, anything you see on it, showing you're not filtering. So eczema, psoriasis, dermatitis, I mean, they got all kinds of friggin' names. Who cares?
Mm-hmm.
This is all your sewer system not filtering. And if your skin isn't filtering, you know which two is it. Because your skin makes up the burden. So when you see psoriasis or you see eczema, I can tell you right off, your other two kidneys are not filtering at all, and your skin barely. And all the burdens shift to the skin. So you know immediately you have to work on your main two kidneys.
Mm-hmm.
First off, and you know on top of them are the adrenal glands. So it goes without saying that lymph, kidney, and adrenals are always the three must-dos. And when it's the GI tract, and I'm telling you the GI tracts are such a mess, we are always, that's always up there. So that's the Fab Four.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to do them. There's no way getting well. And if you want to drain and get up and fix radiosolaris, which are deep genetic weaknesses in the head area, you've got to clean up this gut area. That's why the GI broom, that's why we're all looking for or to make product that will have the best action we can get it.
Many of you have seen my eyes, and if you remember that video or have seen them, you'll see that I had a lot of radiosolaris. and my eyes have went from brown to a lot more green. And those radi isolaris have gotten a lot lighter. But how did I do that? I did heavy lymphatics, heavy kidneys, lots of adrenals, and I did master cleanse after master cleanse, and I did the GI broom solid for a long time.
And she has been, let me tell you. I mean, you look good. You've done incredible. Your blood sugars, this is type 1, almost gone. I mean, you just have done, and you've been working at it. But you know why? 35 years or so on insulin, and we've talked about that, how this is a hormone. I mean, when you're trying to rebuild glands that you've been taking hormones or steroids for 30-some years, it's going to take you a little while.
Yeah.
Because you've set in a consciousness in that gland that you have to rechange.
Well, also, and I'm going to speak on this real quick because I have a lot of people asking me that, I have had to slow way down since I've started working with people because you can't have somebody on your books for 6 weeks and then you call in with a healing crisis that day.
Yeah,
so I've had to slow things down a little bit, too. And then, of course, this last year with school and things like that, I've slowed down even more. But we're getting there. This next year, this is my year next year.
Yeah, you've done good. You've done really good. But it takes that. It's like this little 15-year-old John or what the name. He's been doing great fast and lemon juice fast, and his acne's almost gone. He's had it all his life. And this is the sort of thing it's going to take.
Yeah.
Digging in and going on these tropical diets to eliminate our problems. How beautiful is that, that you can still eat? Because let me tell you, the old days was fasting, water fasting. And so you have a way out, and with using the herbs and the juices, or and just eating the fruit and berries and the melon, you've got a way to get your remedy that's fun, that it might be strict, it might be so far different than society, but it's going back to truth. It's going back to the way your body's designed. But going back to malabsorption, this is just your lymph system blocked in your bowel wall, like it would be blocked in your liver, causing inflammation in the liver, like hepatitis, or pancreatitis in the pancreas, or cystitis in your bladder and urinary tract. It didn't matter where.
At what malabsorption is. You are not absorbing the nutrients properly, and so you're starving the cells. In the GI tract, the small intestine is where you absorb the majority of your nutrients. You've got, and Robert's talked about this, you've got the little villi, those little fingers that absorb that. When you are heavy, most people that I see, the strongest cases of malabsorption, heavy bread, heavy carbohydrate.
Yeah. Oh,
that's glue. That's flour and water. It's starch. And think about this. Your fingers have to wiggle to pick that up, your little villi, to pick that up. If I have somebody pour flour and water on my head and that dries a little bit and cakes on, how easy is it going to be for me to do this?
Rock.
Right through my hair. It's not. It's not going to be.
Yeah.
And when those get stuck and they can't wiggle, you absorb less and less. That's why I love the GI broom. I absolutely love the GI broom because it starts breaking that down and start pulling that, and it starts freeing those little fingers to start wiggling and absorbing again. And I would definitely do some pancreas work on that because most of the people that I see that are malabsorbed, their pancreas is a little
weak. Well, think about this. You know, again, you got your GI tract, and then the pancreas is a branch off that tree. The liver is another branch off the tree. So when you're malabsorbed, you've got liver problems too, and pancreatic problems too, and spleen problems here, and then it works itself up. You got it's just all over because this is a huge system you have down.
Mm-hmm.
It isn't just down over here. You might see a tumor over there on the breast or somewhere, but let me tell you, it's down in your lungs, it's down in your bowels, it's down in your head, it's down everywhere. That's the seriousness of this issue.
Mm-hmm.
These are systems that you have down. These are not little diseases that walk around somewhere in, I don't know, Peyton Place and something like that.
And your cells are like little people. They eat, they drink, they breathe, they drink, they poop, just like you and I do. And if you are starving them, if you're not absorbing your nutrients and you're starving them, so to speak, and then wait a minute. Something big comes against you. Something breaks down, an obstruction. We all know what obstructions are the root of. But what if one day you have to fight off cancer? You've got weak soldiers. You've got starving soldiers. How strong are they going to be at fighting that enemy? It goes all goes back to the lymphatic, your immune system.
Yeah. So I don't know about malabsorption. She's talking about, I think, Ian. We show his picture here with the fruit in a big. I can't remember Ian's journey, but we see this every day in our office here. There's no question that this is a big problem in humans, is malabsorption.
Mm-hmm.
And we see this a lot with our clients, always, you know, complaining about excessive thinness and stuff. But once you understand the reason, you have to understand, you know, how you fix this. And you simply fix it. And you have to understand you're already thin, and you have blockages. Till you remove the blockages, you can't put on the weight. So to remove the blockages, you have to detoxify. That's how you remove blockages. So you're going to lose a little more just because of the nature of the business. But when you get that done, it's going to come right back on you.
Mm-hmm.
But better than ever before. And this time it's going to come on with strong muscle, power muscles, and you're going to feel an energy that you've never felt before. This leads you into major vitality, major energy, major endurance. So these are levels that man hasn't experienced. Some of you have. I've gotten some of you athletes out there so high. I got one guy. I mean, you can become a top winner in every level, in the endurance, everything. It's just, it's amazing the levels you can achieve doing this. That's all I got. This is amazing. I mean, what we get is calls going, how do I stop this energy?
Oh, yeah.
How do I stop all this energy? And that, because it's too much. That's what I'm saying. You're in for a great ride. Have fun doing it. Should always have fun. We want to have fun. We want to be a fun group. Matter of fact, Thursday we're meeting to put together I'm just about done here. Seminar we're going to do. That's exciting to me.
Mm-hmm. I hope it's as exciting to all of you and that you join us in that. It's going to be unreal.
I'm going to have to dance.
No details.
We can't tell them who we're going to invite, who we're going to try to invite.
No details. But we hope it's fun for you.
Yeah, we've got a lot of.
That's what we want. That's our goal, the base of our goal. Unity and fun.
Yeah.
Unity and fun.
Exactly. And single-mindedness, because mm-hmm. as one, we can be so much more powerful. Your job is to keep it simple.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a job, because the mind is always biting at your heels for recognition. It wants to dominate the scene. It's a body. It wants to dominate. And you can't let it dominate, because that's what man's been doing. And so just look around at all the ridiculousness of things, and just the narcissism and the elitisms and all this. This is all educated mind. And you have to, academics is fine with balance and spirituality.
Mm-hmm.
But just academics without spirituality, you're not training the person to stay aware. You're training the mind to dominate.
Oh my goodness.
So then the person loses, and they, their life is not following truth. And so they create more karma, and da 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 da.
Well, understand it's about balance. And when you're off,
I saw
when
that.
You're off, it tilts either way.
If you look in there, I did get a water leak, and I think I have a broke tile back there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know it. Hello, Dr. Morse. First off, I'd like to say I am a regular viewer on your YouTube. Thank you, my friend. Who is this? This is Thomas.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Thomas. Appreciate it, my friend. I would like to thank you for immense knowledge. Thanks, my friend. Appreciate it much. I've been on a plant-based diet for several months now to cure my eczema. Here's another skin problem.
Mm-hmm.
It's all over the place. You notice that? But man's kidneys are down. So look at your skin for your eczema people. You see what that looks like and how bad that looks like? It's at least that bad inside of you.
Mm-hmm.
When you have a diagnosis with cancer, fibromyalgia, lupus, Lyme, all these things, this is all systemic acidosis, chronically so. So you can imagine what your skin looks like on the outside. Take that on the inside, guys. That's why the cancer cells.
I sat down with a cardiac surgeon.
Did you?
And I asked him, I said, so tell me, what does inflammation look like within the body? And he said, think of a third degree burn inside the body. We don't picture what's going on inside the body. We don't picture what that looks like. We know things are there, but we don't picture it. That's why I love iridology. Yeah. Sitting down with somebody and showing them.
Yeah.
Not just sitting there saying, well, you have an issue here, and you have an issue here, and you could potentially face this down the road. You're laying out a map of their body, and you're saying, look at this. Look at this. This is what's happening inside the body right now. And when people see that, they take more responsibility because they're like, oh my goodness, I actually know. I actually see that now.
Such a simple science.
Mm-hmm.
Easy to learn. I love this. This lady knew she had radiosolaris and upper circuit brain and nerve. You got radiosolaris up here? There's two things I can tell you. Upper circuit brain and nerve, and go after your GI tract because that's the instigator. You got to get into your colon, your small bowels, clean them up, just like you were saying. Clean up these bowels, get your kit, go start it where the problems start, kidneys and adrenals, get your lymph moving, and then go after all these tissues with it. And you'll get up in the head, you'll fix these, because these radius solaris are always where the brain lesions are. So, what that shows you, these are genetic weaknesses, and if you don't correct them, in time as you become acidic, more and more acidic up here, they go first.
Yeah.
And that's where I've seen this in CAT scans and everything. That's right where the brain lesions are. So these are pre-brain lesions. If one doesn't already have them, get these deep levels of weakness out of there. And they notice how they go right into near the pupil. That's your stomach and GI tract. And that's the first thing formed when you were in the embryonic stages.
Mm-hmm.
So it just shows you the geneticness of that.
And think about it, for any of you who have ever been in an outhouse, and just the stench.
I think there'll be a lot of them now.
What would that do if you had to sit in that 24/7, day in, day out? When you are toxic here and overloaded, all those vapors, those toxic vapors, rise all along the spine, all along every nerve point to every organ, come up in through here, and end up in the brain. Headaches, dizziness, just fog, all of that. You've got to go after the gut.
You got to. And I'll tell you the way you can tell it, if you stink here. And how many people buy stuff because they stink? That's because, it's dead animals and like
and
you said.
And all they're doing is suppressing the stink.
Oh,
they're pushing that back in.
Oh, yeah.
They're not letting that out.
No. And like,
it's not that it disappears. It's just that it is.
That's it.
Yeah.
It hasn't disappeared. And with antiperspirants, then it shuts down your lymph nodes.
Exactly.
So you shut down your lymph nodes. That's trouble. That's your tumor coming.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the antiperspirants have been blamed for a lot of cancers there. What's he saying here? I've been, he's got eczema and came across to your videos about 2 months ago. Since then, I have upped my food intake to over 90%. My diet, and recently have been consuming 100% fruit on most days. I can tell it is helping a lot. I was interested in purchasing one of your herbs, but I am not sure if I should get one of the kidneys or adrenals. Look forward to hearing back from you. Thomas Wigley, my friend, if you can afford at least the first detox kit, do that, deworm yourself and everything else, then you see the rhythm from which we're going. If you can afford to do the 14-week protocol, I highly recommend it. Get your kidneys filtering, get your adrenals up, check your blood pressures. We're looking for 120 over 60 textbook, something close to that.
If you can only afford a couple herbs, I would do a kidney and an adrenal because the adrenals are the brains of the kidneys, and the kidneys are the filtration for everything.
Yep. You got to do them both. You got to do them both. There's not enough. It's not enough power if I give half of a kidney formula and half of an adrenal in the same formula.
Mm-hmm.
I, you know what I mean? That's why it's two different formulas. You can make one formula hit both, but then you got a little of each one. You don't have the power, in my opinion. So I don't know, but go after this. Go after your GI tract there. Get on some herbs. You see how it's clearing up? Here's another proof. This is another case after case we see this.
But now, you take what you've done here, and you add the adrenal and the kidney, and you watch what you've done multiply.
Oh, yeah. Add the lymph formula in there, add a GI tract formula, and you're cleaning your guy's self up. See, you get in, just like you're going on a mission. You get in, you do your mission, you get out. So you can get in there, you fight for those that don't think they're going to be a raw foodist all their life. Okay. We're not pushing anything like that. You will determine, as the IRS says in high schools, you will determine that you owe, right?
But let me share something on that. If you don't want to be a raw foodist your entire life, that is fine. That is your call. But I will tell you this. This last weekend, I wanted to show how much fun eating raw could be. And so I spent 3.5 hours not cooking in my kitchen, and slaving over a cold stove, so to speak. That's my little joke. I made some amazing raw things. One thing that I did, though, and I should have known, because I've been pretty much fruit all day and a few raw vegetables at night, but for a while, I was craving hummus. I was craving hummus. So I made a coconut curry hummus.
Wow.
To die for, but I suffered for about 36 hours.
I bet you did.
With it.
Yeah, I bet you did.
Stomach rumbling.
Oh, I bet.
Run into the bathroom all the time.
Yeah, I don't eat
when those. You
yeah.
get your body cleaning and your body likes what you're giving it,
yeah.
you won't have to make the decision, do I want to be a raw foodist?
Right.
Your body's going to decide it for you.
Yeah,
you have a bite of steak, and 2-3 bites later, you're sitting there going, oh, I just don't feel good.
Mm-hmm.
We had company for Christmas because my husband was one of these guys where I've traveled all over the United States yet to find a steak when I was eating steak to match his. And we would have people call us and say, can we bring you the meat and have you make it? So for Christmas, this happened. We had friends that wanted to come over and they wanted him to make the food. I don't eat that. And so I got myself some portobello mushrooms.
Yeah.
And I did them for about 5 minutes with some seasonings on the grill. And after the company left, my husband looked at me and he goes, you have no idea how I wish I would have stuck to the mushrooms and the vegetables that you had.
You know, I was thinking.
You feel it.
Yeah. And I was thinking for those that have a more interaction with other people, a social interaction, there's still nothing wrong with you standing up for what you're doing. A lot of people say, well, I go out socially a lot, and so can I cheat when I go out socially? And I'm thinking, why don't you do good when you go out socially and be an example to the rest of your people of what you should be eating instead of just going along with the masses?
Yeah.
That's all we've always done. We'll just go along. We don't want to create any rifts or anything. Why not? Why not show them? Because I guarantee you that they'll be looking at your salad while they're eating their meats and stuff. You watch them. I've watched this for years. They'll be looking at your living foods like this, wanting it, but they're eating their meat. And I mean, I've seen this for years like that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just that you have to be an example sometime.
Yeah.
You don't have to say a lot. Just be the example. Lead by example. Just eat your fruit or eat hard to eat fruit out.
Mm-hmm.
I'd never order fruit in a restaurant, but anyway, go down that road, you know, and have fun with that. This is Sarah, Dr. Morse. I've been on the road to Wellville for a little over 2 years. Damn long road, ain't it? I am inspired to reach out to others in the community,
mm-hmm.
just what we're talking about. And formerly, I put together a Facebook page called Hellville to Wellville. Yeah! Oh, wow, this is good.
Yes.
It's just in the beginning stages and it is work in progress, so are all of us. Yes. Feel free to share this information with others. This page is for sharing experiences, encouragement, and support. Facebook. Hellville to Wellville, guys. Peace and enlightenment. This is Sarah May. Thank you, Sarah. Appreciate that. You know, the beauty of all of this is you have beautiful souls. Places, people, these beings that come from the same place you do.
Mm-hmm.
And they're all in trouble and needing your help. So when someone is out there, it just gets your heart to help these people. Like looking at these babies, we just can no longer live in that level, at this level here. We need to infuse it a little bit. So appreciate this Facebook stuff. Any help that you can help people make it through. There are healing crises. Some of them are tough.
Yeah.
You know, but most of them are not. Most of them are cold and flu-like symptoms, a little ache and pain here and there. Some are pretty big pains in places of weaknesses or decay and atrophy, but you work through them.
Yep.
You can use oils like any oil.
Frankincense
will do. You can olive oil will do even, but yeah, castor oil or hemp oil or even grapeseed will suck right in there. All helping with anti-inflammatories, but you know what you got to do. And this is in every single case. You don't have to go, well, your case is special. You got all these problems, and I don't know quite what I'm going to do with you because you've got all these problems. Realize that all roads lead to Rome. Most of man's problems lead to one system, the lymphatic mm-hmm. system and acidosis, and you can take that to the bank.
Yeah.
And then when you do, it doesn't matter, because when you assume that and go that way, they're going to get well no matter what anyway. And you can't lose.
And always go back to why. Why, and go to the deepest why that you can. Number of people that are, well, I'm in this state because of candida, or I am in this state because of H. pylori, or whatever. Well, why do you have candida? Why do you have H. pylori? Why do you have parasites? Your body is designed to deal with all of that. Mm-hmm. Always go to why. Don't blame another disease for your issue. Yeah. I had somebody ask recently, I have lupus, and I've heard that that's because of Lyme's disease. You're just blaming another disease. Go to the root. Go to the immune system. Your immune system was designed to fight even cancer. It was designed to get rid of it. Cancer is just a damaged cell that has not been eliminated because the lymphatic system isn't flowing
That's
properly.
That's it. That's all it is.
That's all it is.
And people freak out about that. Tumors. Nobody dies of tumors unless they're pressing on something vital. But you've got time to get all this out. What people do die is in the treatment. Of course, we've laid that out to you considerably. Mm-hmm. We've got more studies now going up. We're getting prepared now to throw videos up for you. We got some fun things. And we all need to keep working together and have fun with this. Throw it in the public's yes. face. This time, this is about public awareness. This is what you haven't been shown. And that's including the medical doctors. Because there's a lot of great medical doctors that never been told the truth.
Your congressmen are sitting there, and there are people coming in that are speaking lies to them.
Yep.
That this whole vaccine thing, mm-hmm. they brought in a lady who, she was just a, vaccines are good for you. Vaccines are needed. There is no medical evidence whatsoever that says vaccines are bad for you or causes autism. All the while, knowing these were out there, these tests and these things going on. And yet she is sitting there lying to your congressman. So this isn't just about us sharing information and educating you guys. It is about getting it in front of the congressmen and the ones that can make a difference if they have the truth. And if they choose not to make that difference.
They did. But you know what? This is why us becoming one is essential. Our babies. I mean, if you take a look at what they have planned, our babies haven't got a chance in hell.
Yeah.
Because the average person that doesn't know how to get healthy, the baby's genetics are so weak right now that you're almost guaranteed to have some problems with your babies at some level or not. And I'm telling you, the way it is now, remember, cancer's in every other person supposedly, so that's also true in the infants, so every other infant supposedly has cancer or something. So it doesn't matter about those sort of statistics, but it's enough to say that man is in deep crap, and so is the babies. And you can't afford to have your baby. You got to be real careful. Babies are coming in toxic. They're coming in weak kidneys and adrenals, weak digestive tracts, and the nervous systems are a mess. Nervous systems are so much of a mess that one shot of vaccine throws them into seizures. Didn't used to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not understanding that man is more toxic and weak than ever before. They must think everybody comes through the chute healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Something, because they don't take for the differences or variances in toxemia in people.
Mm-hmm.
And the various genetic weaknesses that will not allow or that create such a toxic lymph system. Plus, look at all the mothers that are lymphatically toxic that are having babies and now making their babies toxic for them. Because they don't know any better.
Babies are hooked to the mom for nine
That's
months.
That's it. And they don't know any better. So this is why education at this level is vital. And why we're so enthusiastic, to say the least, about this.
Yeah.
Especially when you see these friggin' pictures and stuff like this. It makes you sick to your stomach. Thanks, Doc. Sorry if went sideways this week. I know that there was a lot of healing in part of it, but it did not look so nice to anyone from the outside. I don't know what we're talking about.
Are you talking about the YouTube stuff?
I don't know. I hope things move forward from here. It hurts me that it hurts you. You have mentioned about this connection to God. I am very interested in this. It took me a while to make the decision to work with the clinic because of the cost, and I had hoped to make that spiritual connection with you, but was told you are no longer seeing patients. But you'll see me. We're going to have fun. We got our classes. We're going to have these seminars. Listen, we're going to have some fun together.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have some fun together, guys.
And I want you to understand one thing. Jen and I and anyone that Robert brings on here, when you see us, you're seeing Robert. He handpicked us and he has trained us. So I understand the celebrity status and wanting to see Robert, but I want you to also understand that when you see us, you're hearing exactly what Robert would tell you. And we go over stuff all the time.
All the time. We have trainings all the time because this is, we all have to speak from one voice. If we don't, they'll win. Divide and conquer has always been the way. And we have suffered at the hands of allopathy, FDA, and Department of Justice beyond what we need to from now on. Mm-hmm. We need to stand up and claim this because I have to, because if I don't, I'm probably not going to go home. So, no, we have to do this.
Things like this can't be relied upon on one person. Right. We couldn't voice that and get that and educate the people, the masses that need to be educated through one person. That's why there's YouTube videos. That's why we're training practitioners and things like that.
And you guys, too.
And you guys. For you to start going and sharing and healing on your own and taking this out there and spreading it so that it does get into the hands of the remotest parts of the world that need it just as bad as here in the States.
The stories I'm hearing from you guys are pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
You're helping a lot of people, and I'm so proud of you guys. You know, be proud of yourselves because this is a big deal. I mean, take a look at the world. What are you going to do that is more satisfying than helping others that are suffering? What could you do that's more satisfying to you and put you right with everything? Yeah. Not much.
When you get a letter from someone who is so thankful because their doctor doesn't understand, but they no longer have
leukemia. Or anything like that.
Terminal leukemia.
Feels good,
and you see the gratitude for this office, and you guys are going to start getting these same letters to you thanking you. There is nothing. I went to bed that night so thankful that I am in a position that I can be part of this.
Me too, because all I can say is that these people are dying for no reason, and when you can step and help them on their journeys, these are souls on their long journeys, and you're being part of that positive, that gives you positive energy and your journey even better.
Yeah.
So in all ways, all I can say here, this is why when my first kid came to the house, I decided to take it quite seriously and go with grape juice and getting my body in shape. So I'm asking for this connection to God that you speak about. Well, I'll be in just a few minutes and we'll go. Okay. I've been kind of giving you clues and kind of intertwining, interlacing spirituality with these discussions because it's hard to just speak spirituality when this site is a health site and I don't want to upset too many people. But at the same time, the mind and emotions is very much involved in your health issues and in those that are not getting well.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you're struggling and you're doing everything right, then check the mind and check the emotions. Because either your mind or your emotions is blocking your physical body from getting well. And we see that. You're either anal, you're the A type, or whatever. Your heart's not open, you're too stressed, you're too opinionated, or any
fear.
Of these things. Fear, too much fear, all of these things. You've got to throw all that crap to the side and claim your existence. Claim your right to beingness because you are here. And claim that. Claim that over the mind and emotions and over others. You're here for this is your journey. So just be strong in that way, you know, and you'll win the day. But some people are working harder than others for their health. And they're for many reasons. Some of you have a little deeper karma, if you want to call it, a little deeper situation in the body, a little deeper lymphatic problem, a little deeper genetics. Everybody's uniquely different. So we can't tell at 6 months you'll be done with this. 6 months you'll be walking. Like I told that one girl with MS, 6 months, took her 7. Oh, I'm sorry. But at least she was walking.
So that's probably the biggest question I get is how long is this going to take?
Exactly.
And I don't want it to sound like a pat answer when we say, you know, I can't really tell you because I don't know your layers. I don't know when you're going to bump up against an emotion. I don't know when you're going to bump up against some spiritual issues. I don't know when you're going to bump up against things. And that can cause a delay and an interference in that healing.
Yes, 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 this is true. There's so many factors that a practitioner has to take in consideration when they're helping someone. And the only way you can really see that, excuse me, is to step back. Get out of your mind as a practitioner and observe. They'll tell you exactly what's wrong. They'll show you. Because when you're observing your clients, you can see their mental problems. You can see their emotional problems. If you're observing, if you're too busy thinking that and planning and everything that what they need, you sit back and let the universe tell you. That's your own awareness view, and watch them talk and communicate with you, because your clients will tell you everything about themselves.
They will. And
give you the little secrets of where their hooks are, and then you can help unwind them for them and stuff, you know.
But what does that take? That takes you connecting with them. Because if you don't connect with them, if they don't sense that you care, then they're not going to share that stuff. Yeah. I had a situation, and I think I've shared this before, but a gentleman come in very irate. Drew was trying to help him and answer his questions, and he just kept getting more and more so. And so I went out, and I just, what's going on? And I didn't interrupt him. I didn't try and answer his questions. I let him talk for 5 minutes. And finally, I started addressing his questions one after the other. But in letting him talk for 5 minutes, he was experiencing, he'd been to doctor after doctor after doctor who would not listen to him. And so when he come in and you just listen to him for a couple minutes, that appeases that. Do you realize in the average doctor's appointment, a doctor cuts a person off within the first 18 seconds? They're not interested in your issues. They don't care that your dad died. They don't care the emotional things that are going on. They don't even necessarily care. And I'm not saying they don't care. I'm saying they don't have the answer for that. They have a prescription pad. And, I will say that I think there are a lot of doctors that got into it to help people. Mm-hmm. But the way they were trained and the things they were taught suck them into a side that limits them.
Exactly.
It limits them. It limits what they can do.
Yeah, and if you're one of those medical doctors, come join us, because mm-hmm. the level of healing you can attain in others is staggering and needed at this late date in our chronic, because you have to realize we're at the chronic and degenerative levels. That's what they don't understand. We're not back in the acute, subacute stages. Mm-hmm. No. We're in the serious chronic and degenerative stages. You're not going to fix those things up with the snap of a finger. Back when things were just acute, you could take a pharmaceutical and aspirin or something, bam, it's all gone, no big deal. Oh, thanks, that took care of it. Mm-hmm. Didn't realize that you were starting the suppression game. The game of suppressing your body's ability to heal itself when you had a symptom. In natural health, we expectorate, we promote elimination, and that fixes you for good. Because when you see a symptom, that means you have a blockage or you have chemistry in the body that needs to get out. There's no other reason to have a symptom.
Yeah.
Something's in there, it shouldn't be in there. How'd you get it in there?
What happens when you take a child who for years is angry, but that anger is suppressed, and that anger is suppressed? At some point, they're going to explode. And our jails are full.
Oh, yeah.
Our jails are full of people who have suppressed emotions and suppressed emotions. What happens when you start doing that and you start suppressing symptoms and you start pushing down symptoms and things like that within the body? One day it's going to explode. Exactly. You will no longer be able to take a pill to suppress that. You're going to have to deal with it. In my world, or should I say my opinion, it is far better to prevent than it is to fix.
Far better. Far better. No question about it. Especially when you have a raging bull.
Yeah. After the accident has occurred, you got to fix many of the little areas. If you can get to that before an accident happens, then you can focus in and fix.
I tell you what, I will give you a spiritual video coming, and we'll talk just spiritual on that video, and we won't talk about the health side of that. But we've been interlacing this with this, so you don't get upset that this is an awakening time. This is how you build awareness, and I've been giving you all clues of how you stop the mind, you observe, that's how you connect. Because as soon as you stop playing the game of the mind and emotions, you're home. You're home here. There, you are the center awareness of everything. The awareness your mind has comes from you. But the thoughts and the analysis and the way the mind functions is the mind. It's so slick, you can't hardly tell when you're thinking and when you're just being awake and aware. That's the slickness of how God is. I almost can't tell the difference between thought and emotions even. It's got so slick, and they're all wrapped around the human body. You can't even, the human body's just a chemical body. It has basically five senses, that's it. But your emotions are a much bigger level of yourself, and your mind, of course, unbelievably bigger. They're still just aspects of creation you're playing with. It isn't you, but when you allow those aspects to dominate you, then you've lost your consciousness, your awareness. And Jesus and Buddha, all these beautiful beings say the same thing. At least a little, each one in their own words, but if you read them, they're the same thing. And they're telling you, detach yourself from your desires. Be free from that. Jesus was a big proponent of freedom. So was Buddha. You know, and they talked about detachment and living free from your desires. Doesn't mean you can't have something, but be free from it. If you go out and buy something and it breaks tomorrow, who cares? Like if you have in a tornado and your house is destroyed, or your pretty picture, who cares? What's real is you. Creation is something here today, gone tomorrow. You look here 1 minute, you look over here the next, you look over here the next. This is gone now because now you're over here. Now I'm over here, now that's all gone. This is life and creation, but you are always in each experience you have, because that center awareness is the real you. When the mind starts thinking, you start losing that into thoughts. You get to that core, and you're in the first stages of going home at levels you can't even imagine.
And you know what is absolutely beautiful? When you can learn to be in the moment, you will discover that within that moment can be beautiful moments.
Everywhere. Oh, yeah. So the spiritual side is so cool. When we do the seminar, that's all I'm going to do. I'm going to shift in the next couple of years from health stuff, because you guys have all this. She's in Jen, and of course Attila's coming up. We have plenty of great counselors. They know their stuff. Marcy and I are digging. Even Jim B, we're all sharing and digging into research and information, and to put it up for you guys, the spiritual side is the big one. And that's where I need to shift a little bit more into. It's hard, even though it's all the same, it's hard to kind of...
And understand that God is always talking. He's always sharing. It's when we get too busy here. I have something in my office that says, Lord, silence me that I may hear your whisper. And
well, that's a big problem.
Yeah.
And that's the difference between prayer and meditation as a rule. No offense to anybody, but prayer is generally the petition or the conversation of God from you to God. How about just what Marcy said? Listen.
Mm-hmm.
And the first thing to listen for is the music, because spirit, whatever you wish to call the essence that flows through all life, makes music as it flows, depending on what level you're at.
Mm-hmm.
And you listen to that inner music, and you'll see what level you're at. We'll get more into that in the spiritual side of this, but there, all these levels have different music tones. And you
listen
can
to this. Okay, so it's been scientifically proven that everything has its own vibration.
Mm-hmm.
If you listen to that vibration,
mm-hmm.
it is singing. Everything has a song.
Mm-hmm.
The trees, the crystals.
Everything.
The rocks.
Oh.
The hills.
Oh.
In fact, it says somewhere in Scripture that if you wouldn't sing out, praise me, even the rocks and the hills would cry out.
Yeah.
Because everything has a song. Everything has a song.
Isn't that beautiful? I love all of that. And it's just, when you start merging in with all of life, then you feel all of life. And then you can look at a flower and love it for its beauty, and it's giving you back beauty. It's just so, it's like the herbs the same way. These guys, when you're used to using herbs, you start to realize how vital they are over the foods. Matter of fact, you could just live off herbs and eat them because they're all vitamins and minerals, all the other nutrition, mm-hmm. the flavonoids, the cumarins, all of that stuff, all in the herbs. So these are food sources with a twist.
Yeah.
Those guys know they were brought here for you. They were brought here for the kidneys of man and animals. They're here to help.
Yeah.
Everything. And when you get into that level of conscious, instead of ostracizing yourself as something cold and different from everybody else, that's not consciousness, that's the mind. Then your life is reduced and not happy and conflictual and constipated.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's fun stuff. This is so much fun. Read one more and then we'll go.
Yep.
Could you please ask Dr. Morse to address the question of total hair loss that happened within 2-week period? Holy crap. Well, that's scary. A 2-week period and someone lost all their hair. Now, I could see that in detoxification. I don't think we've ever seen too much of that in detox, although we have seen people a little more speeding of the hair falling. You have to realize one thing.
Mm-hmm.
When you start detoxifying, the body is going to get rid of, and we haven't talked enough about this, but the body is going to get rid of its weaknesses.
Mm-hmm.
It already tries to do that. You watch tumors and the way they go, they're trying to get out of the body. They're looking for holes.
Mm-hmm.
The body's trying to shove this stuff out, whether it's through the nipple, whether it's through the mouth, whether it's through the ears, the eyes, whatever, whole belly buttons. Your body's trying to get rid of this stuff. Where would anybody in the health field think that suppressing that action would be a good thing?
Mm-hmm.
No, not a good thing. We don't like the symptoms when we expectorate toxins. We don't like how we feel when we have cold and flus and the mucuses are coming out. Then you don't put it in.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't like what's coming out, don't put it in. It's that simple.
If you're in a building that's flooded, you're going to look for a window, a door, or any way you can to escape.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you could, now she hasn't stated whether she was on a detox or not, but you could, on a detox, start losing hair just for the very nature of it, to be honest with you. It's going to come right back. We don't have that picture. I think we did show it up here. Remember the lady,
mm-hmm.
the hair was all gone here. She grew it all back beautifully. Her skin was a nightmare and how beautiful she is. You can grow everything back, guys. You just got what takes things off. That's the scary part here, is when you understand acidosis and you look at cancer cells and you realize acids and what they do, then you start getting a real good picture of what we're all up against. And when you realize that hair follicles are removed by acids, that whole understanding of inflammation underlying, you just got to understand, you have to fix that problem,
mm-hmm.
first, and then everything will regrow and rebuild. It's guaranteed to do that. But you have to fix the why first. And if you weren't on a detox program, that's serious.
I'd be looking at environmental things. What's going on?
Environmental, I'd be working in some kind of gnarly chemistry you just ingested, or this person's just lymphatic system is at the point that it just,
yep.
not good.
Something shut that down for a 2-week elimination quickly.
Yeah, that's awful quick. It's enough to say, though, when you lose hair, it's all about lymph stagnation in the scalp and acidosis.
Mm-hmm.
Plain and simple. You fix that, you have your hair back. You don't fix that, you'll be bald, and then you'll be going, did I drive my car or my truck here? I don't have either one.
Yeah.
I mean, that sort of thing. You know what I mean? You mean I walked? my friend had a full head of hair and all other normal hair and lost it all suddenly without any apparent reason. Well, there's a reason. Whether you, the one thing we can't see, thank God, is what's going on under the skin in humans. Someone made that comment on YouTube a couple of years ago. All these beautiful people walking around, how could they all be toxic and sick, mm-hmm. you know? De-skin them. I've seen some of the most beautiful women out there, but when I looked at their eyes, not so pretty inside.
Mm-hmm.
You see that a lot on TV with the models, and they look so pretty on the outside. Then they show you up close on the eye, and you go, oh, chronic bowels.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a trouble about knowing too much.
Malabsorption out the walls.
Oh, yeah.
You get some of them?
Yeah, yeah. Their bodies look nice. Oh, malabsorption, you're trying to
By the way, wazoo is a scientific. I just made that.
Is it wazoo? Is that a scientific? Well, you know, Webster should be adding wazoo in there. Right now, they add all the other stuff. I think Black's Law Dictionary should add wazoo.
No, you're
And that's under the judges.
Yeah.
I would like to write you a longer message, but this
Yeah, but look at this. It has now been 1 year and no hair has come back.
That's not good. Because
this isn't a breakdown in detox, or you'd have seen that hair starting to come back.
Oh, yeah. This is Emily. Else. This is a female, too. So that's not, and that's to you, Marcy Troyer.
Mm-hmm.
They'll come back, Emily. But I would use upper circuit brain and nerve and fix this GI tract so you can drain your sinuses and all mm-hmm. that. If you want to do some hot and cold applications to the head, okay. Do the neural lymphatics down the back
absolutely.
So you can move that even better.
Start doing some lymphatic stretches in the neck mm-hmm. area. Get mm-hmm. this vagus note. Understand your vagus tone. That's deep breathing. That's very important because that helps move this lymph mm-hmm. right here.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff. Good stuff. Well, we love you all, and we thank you for watching these videos. I know sometimes we get a little quirky and stuff, but when you see these vaccine pictures
yeah.
of our babies, and it's all because of idiocy, that if you have a medium and you go out where you have virals that are flying around or bacteria, you're a host always. The level of host you are depends on the level of toxemia that you have in you. In other words, how backed up is your sewer system?
Mm-hmm.
This is all sewage stuff. But the problem is we have a lot of neurotoxicity in the world as well. So when you look at the adrenal glands, part of all this sewage trash and everything, it is also very much a part of your nervous system, at least the autonomic. So then we start having those problems. And it just is very serious. The illusion of all of this is that everything's different. Different diseases and stuff. And it fooled the medical doctors pretty good, didn't it? So God goes, pretty good. Fooled them. However, you can't be fooled anymore. You realize that everything comes from the same thing. Your lifestyle. Don't let anybody tell you what you eat has nothing to do with
absolutely.
Your suffering. Or you're living in Disneyland.
Your car, if it required premium unleaded and you put diesel in it, you wouldn't be going very far. If it's important what type of fuel you put in your car, how much more important is it the fuel that you put in your own system?
So much. I have a diesel truck and I always afraid I'll have some moment of relapse or I'm thinking about a Majul date and putting gas in it.
Understand one thing. There's some tough stuff ahead. There's some big things that are coming. You do not want to be stuck in a place where you can't get a hold of your medication because of some stuff going on. Let's work at getting off the medication. Get yourself healthy. Be prepared for things that are coming. That's not to scare you. That's not. That's just to say, be ready. Be prepared.
Right. Yeah, she's right. And I mentioned this before. This world's got some tough knocks to go through, but
mm-hmm.
we're standing here, and as long as you're free within your consciousness, nothing can hurt you. Because if it does, it just hurts your body. Can't hurt you. Nothing can hurt you. Nothing can kill you. You just simply move your attention away from it, from that body to something else. You just got to play with this. And we'll talk about contemplation, meditation, and how you can use that to practice this. But listening, that is totally a great. So let's make this the spiritual exercise of the week. And so when you go into a spiritual exercise, you want to find a place where you can just totally relax. Even if you lay down, I don't care how you sit, but you want to just totally relax and listen.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to the inner music. And when you hear that music, it can be the sound of birds, a single note of the flute. It can sound like an orchestra. It can sound like crickets. Surrender to that sound.
It can sound like a whisper.
It can sound like a whisper. And oftentimes is.
Mm-hmm.
Surrender to that and let it pull you and surround you and consume you. Pretty soon you'll find yourself at that plane. Fun stuff. All kinds of fun stuff. So we'll see you on the next video. And thank you so much for taking your precious time. Be careful about vaccines.
Yes.
It's a very serious problem we have in here.
If you have a child that is going to be born soon, grandchild, child, study up on this. Make sure you know what you're giving your child.
Yeah, you don't want to end up having these babies like this. I just
these reactions did not happen because for no reason.
Exactly.
They happened for a reason.
Exactly.
You don't want to be the mother that's watching your child suffer like this.
No. And there's been a lot of lucky mothers. But at what level is your child suffering? So we just have to fix everybody, make everybody healthy, not worry about it, enjoy the world at a different level.
Mm-hmm.
So We'll see you again. Thank you so much. We love you all. Take care of yourselves. And watch your dreams. You might get some juicy kisses. Bye-bye.